So in this short video, I'm going to explain the various dimensionless groups which are used in mass transfer and in heat transfer. So the first number under mass transfer is Schmidt number. Now Schmidt number is usually represented by SC. It is the ratio of momentum diffusivity to molecular diffusivity. So let me write it. So mathematically, the Schmidt number can be represented as the momentum diffusivity by molecular diffusivity. So momentum diffusivity can be written as nu, which is also known as the kinematic viscosity. And this molecular diffusivity is written as dAb. It is represented by dAb. So now the corresponding analogous number which is used in heat transfer to the Schmidt number is, it is the Prandtl number. Now Prandtl number is represented by PR. It is represented by PR. Mathematically, it is the ratio of momentum diffusivity to thermal diffusivity. So let me write it down. Now momentum diffusivity can be written as same. It is the kinematic viscosity, so it will be written as nu. But this thermal diffusivity is represented by alpha. Now if I expand this further, this nu can be written as dynamic viscosity divided by the density, and this alpha can be written as K divided by rho Cp. The K is the thermal conductivity. So rho will get cancelled, and this entire term can be written as mu Cp divided by K. Mu Cp divided by K. So this is the expression for Prandtl number. Prandtl number and Schmidt number are the analogous numbers for corresponding mass and heat transfer operations. So now we will move on to the second number. So the second important group is the Sherwood number. It is the ratio of convective mass flux to the diffusive flux across a layer of thickness L. Now Sherwood number is denoted by SH. So if I write it mathematically, it is something like this: HL divided by dAb, where H is the mass transfer coefficient. So let me denote this by HM. Then it will be easy to distinguish between mass and heat. So now I will discuss for heat. So for heat, the analogous number to this Sherwood number is, it is the Nusselt number. Nusselt number is denoted by, it is denoted by nu. It is the ratio of convective heat flux to the conduction heat flux across a layer of thickness L. Now it is similar to what I have shown over here. It is mathematically expressed as HL by K, where H is the heat transfer coefficient. K is the thermal conductivity. So this is what K is. So this is the expression for Nusselt number, and for Sherwood number, this is the expression. Now let's move on to the third point. So the third number that we have is the Stanton number. It is denoted by ST. But for mass, I will write a small m at the bottom. So this is what Stanton number for mass is. So it is defined as, it is the ratio of convective mass flux to the flux due to bulk flow of the medium. So this is what Stanton number for mass is. So if I represent it mathematically, it is something like this. It is equal to Sherwood number divided by Reynolds number times Schmidt number. So this is what Stanton number is for mass. And for heat, so Stanton number for heat is represented by ST with a small h in the bottom. Now it is equal to convective heat flux to the heat flux due to the bulk flow. Mathematically, it is represented by Nusselt number, Reynolds number into Prandtl number. So if you remember any one of these, deriving the other is very easy. The analogous number to Sherwood number is Nusselt number, and the analogous number to Schmidt number is Prandtl number. So for Stanton number for heat equals to Nusselt number by Reynolds number into Prandtl number, and Stanton number for mass equal to Sherwood number by Reynolds number into Schmidt number. So fourth, we have this Peclet number. For mass transfer, this Peclet number is represented by PE with a M, and for heat transfer, it is denoted with PE with an H. This is for heat transfer. So Peclet number is defined as, so for mass, Peclet number equal to flux due to the bulk flow of the medium divided by diffusive flux across a layer of thickness L. This is the Peclet number for mass. it is equal to Reynolds number times Schmidt number, which is denoted by SC. So this is the Peclet number for mass, and the Peclet number for heat equal to heat flux due to the bulk flow divided by conduction flux across the thickness L. So it is represented by Reynolds number times the Prandtl number. This is what is the Peclet number for heat. So now let's move on to, so next is the Colburn factor. Now Colburn factor for mass is, so Colburn factor is represented by JD, this is for mass transfer, is equal to Stanton number for mass times the Schmidt number to the power 2/3. So if I replace this Stanton number by the definition Sherwood number by Reynolds number times the Schmidt number. So this is what the Stanton number for mass is, times SC to the power 2/3. So if I simplify this, it becomes Sherwood number divided by Reynolds number times the Schmidt number to the power 1 - 2/3, which is equal to 1/3. So this is what the Colburn factor for mass transfer is. This is for mass. And now for heat. So Colburn factor for heat is represented by JH. STH is the Stanton number for heat and PR is the Prandtl number. So again, if I expand this, the Stanton number for heat can be written as Nusselt number divided by Reynolds number times the Prandtl number. And we have Prandtl number to the power 2/3. So if I simplify this, it becomes Nusselt number divided by Reynolds number times Prandtl number to the power 1/3. So this is what the expression are. You can see that these are completely analogous to each other. The Sherwood number for mass becomes the Nusselt number for heat, and the Schmidt number for mass becomes the Prandtl number for heat. Reynolds number remains the same on both the occasions. So the next important thing which we are going to study is the Reynolds analogy. So Reynolds analogy states that Cf by 2 is equal to Stanton number for mass is equal to Stanton number for heat. This is the analogy. The Stanton number for mass equals to the Stanton number for heat equals to the friction factor by 2 for Schmidt number equal to Prandtl number equal to 1, which implies that the Lewis number equal to 1. So this is the condition and this is the result. So this is the condition that for Lewis number equal to 1, we can have this analogy that the Stanton number for mass will be equal to the Stanton number for heat will be equal to the friction factor by 2. This is the Reynolds analogy. So this Lewis number is the ratio of Schmidt number and Prandtl number. So next we will discuss the Chilton-Colburn analogy. So this analogy states that the Colburn factor for mass, which is represented by JD, is equal to the Colburn factor for heat is equal to the friction factor by 2. This is what this analogy says. So I can expand this further and write as the Colburn factor for mass is given by Stanton number for mass times the Schmidt number to the power 2/3. So this equal to the Colburn factor for heat, which is equal to the Stanton number for heat times the Prandtl number to the power 2/3. This is equal to the friction factor by 2. So on further simplifying, this becomes, so the Stanton number for mass can be written as Sherwood number by Reynolds number times Schmidt number. And this, if I take the simplification of this entire term, then this Schmidt number to the power 2/3 will come below. So same for heat we have the Nusselt number by Reynolds number times the Prandtl number to the power 1 - 2/3. This is equal to the Cf by 2. So the last step is the last simplification. This becomes Sherwood number by Reynolds number times Schmidt number to the power 1/3. This is equal to the Nusselt number by Reynolds number times the Prandtl number to the power 1/3 is equal to the friction factor by 2. So this is the final expression for the Chilton-Colburn analogy. So these were the various dimensionless groups and the analogies between mass transfer and heat transfer operations. Thank you.